Good morning, my dear friends. Myself Venkatesh, Department of CSC, DBS IT, Kavali. Today we are going to discuss about a topic called as runtime environment or runtime storage management. Both are similar words. So it is in the subject of compiler design. See, what is a runtime environment in compiler design? First, we will see the brief introduction about a runtime environment. See, a runtime environment in compiler design deals variety of issues such as managing the processor stack, layout and allocation of memory for various variables used in the source program, allocating and deallocating the memory dynamically with the help of operating system, the mechanism used by the target program to access variables, and finally the mechanism to pass variables. All these are the various varieties of issues that are in the environment of runtime. Whereas if you take any program, normally if you take any program, either it is a C program or Java program or Python program or C sharp program, whenever we save the program, then the program will be stored in hard disk. All of you very well known about this thing. During compilation also, program resides in hard disk only. But a processor or a CPU can execute a program only when the program resides in main memory only. So we can say that if the program resides in main memory, then only a CPU or processor can execute that program. So after compilation is over, the compiler demands a block of memory from the operating system in order to store that program in main memory. Why? Because it is the responsibility of the operating system to manage resources such as memory and files and input output devices. You know very well about the responsibilities of the operating system. So one of the major responsibility of the operating system is memory management. So operating system allocates free block of memory to the corresponding program. So the compiler uses a free block of memory in order to store that compiled program. This is called as runtime storage management. See, the name itself, we have the meaning. So runtime means it is nothing but execution time. So how a program is stored during execution time is called as a runtime storage management. See here, if you see the diagram here, actually we can divide the main memory into four parts. See, first part contains code area, and the second part we have static data area, and the next one is heap area, the next one is stack area. In between heap and stack, we have some free memory. This free memory can be utilized by both heap area as well as stack area. Here, first of all, what is a code area? See, code area means during compilation only, the size of the program will be decided. We know very well about this thing. So before execution, the size of the program will be decided. So what is the main agenda, main use of the code area is, code area mainly stores the executable code only. After compilation, linking will happen. We know what is linking very well. So linking means it links object code of several library files into a single file. Linker produces a file called executable file. So the code area contains target executable code only. See, the major purpose of the code area is it can store the executable code only. And the second one is static data area. So what is the main purpose of static data area? So static data area means it is mainly used to store the static variables as well as global variables. So what is a static variable? What is a global variable? So global variable in the sense it is useful throughout the program, whereas static variable means the value of the variable is persistence. Whereas again here we have two areas are there, that is heap and stack. In order to utilize space in an efficient manner, heap and stack areas are mainly used. Here stack grows from high address space to low address space. Here we have high address space, here we have low address space, whereas stack grows from high address space to low address space, whereas heap grows from low address space to high address space. These two growths are opposite to each other. Whereas next, coming to the stack area, we know stack works on the principle of last in first out, that is LIFO. Whenever a function or procedure is called, then an activation record gets created. In order to store activation record information, stack is used. So what is the main purpose of stack? To store activation record information, we are going to use the stack. And activation record pushed onto the top of the stack. So again, next come to the heap area. So heap means, heap is a dynamic data structure just like as a stack. In order to allocate memory at runtime, we use heap area. So for example, if we take a C language, we have various functions like malloc, realloc, colloc and free functions. By using these functions, we can allocate and reallocate and delete the memory at runtime. You know very well about all these things. And if you take Java, in Java also we have two operators like new operator and delete operator. That is, new operator is for allocating the memory, whereas delete operator is for deallocation of memory. So these two data structures are used depending upon the situation. If there are too many functions or procedures, then stack is used more often, that is free memory occupied by the stack. That means if we have too many functions, then this free memory can be utilized, more free memory can be utilized by the stack. Whereas if there are too many dynamic variables or too many pointer variables, then we need to allocate memory, that memory for pointer variables. So that should be done with the help of the heap. That means if a program contains too many pointer variables, though at that time the majority of the free memory can be utilized by the heap area only. So this is the regarding memory utilization. That means subdivision of runtime memory. The memory can be divided into four major areas: code area, static data area, and a heap area, and a stack area. So next, come to the next one is stack allocation of space. So what is stack allocation of space? Let us see some introduction about the stack allocation of space. Almost all compilers for languages that use procedures, functions or methods as unit of user-defined actions manage at least part of their runtime memory as a stack. Each time a procedure is called, space for its local variable is pushed on a stack, and when the procedure terminates, automatically that space is popped up of the stack. So what is a activation record? So activation record, in the sense, why we are using this activation record? Whenever a function or procedure call occurs, then an activation record gets created. and activation record information pushed onto the top of the stack. Here in this diagram we will see the model of the activation record, that means, or we can say the various fields of activation records. We have actually, there are 7 fields are there in activation records. So first one is actual parameters, second one is return values, third one is control or dynamic links, next one is access or static link, next one is saved machine status, next one is local variables, next one is temporary variables. So first one is actual parameters. So why we are using this actual parameters? We know what are the actual parameters. Actual parameters are nothing but the parameters which are declared inside the calling function. So the main in this, what is actual parameter field use? It holds the actual parameters of calling function. So the major purpose is it holds the actual parameters of calling function. Whereas comes and next one is returned values. So returned values means it is mainly useful in order to store the result of function call. Whenever a function is called, then it goes to the function definition. Once function definition was successfully executed, it may return value to the calling function. In order to store that value, we use return value. Next one is control link. It points to the activation record of calling function. In order to store the address of the calling function, activation record, we use control link. And next one is access link. It refers to the local data of called function, but function in another activation record. That means we can store local data of called function by using the access link. Next, fifth one is saved machine status. It can store address of the next instruction to be executed. It is just like as a register to store address of the next instruction. So next one is, next field is local variables. So you know about very well about the local variables. These variables are local to any function. So whereas comes under temporary variables, the temporary variables mainly used, for example, if we need any expression, so if we want to evaluate any expression, during the evolution of that expression we need the temporary variables. So all these are the various fields comes under activation record. Thank you very much.